Hi everyone, welcome to our demo session of our Azure Cielo qPCR system, or Real-Time PCR system. So I'm Ting Ting, a product specialist from Exo Scientific Instrument Division. So what you are seeing here today with us is our 6-channel qPCR system, Azure Cielo 6, so capable of multiplexing up to 6 dyes. So today I will show you the operation of this system, as well as the software on board as well. So I would like to highlight that our system is designed for individual well scanning with 2 sets of 16 optic fibers, which means that it will simultaneously scan 16 single wells with 2 sets of optic fiber for each well. So using highly powered 6-channel specific LEDs for excitation and emission. So this is to increase the sensitivity and accuracy for obtaining your results. So we understand that for qPCR systems, all your samples that you are dealing with is really important. So you will require such precision and accuracy in every run. So firstly, our system is compatible with all non-skirted or semi-skirted low-profile 96 well plates. So they are easily available from Exo Scientific. So otherwise, Azure Biosystems has also released their newest 96 well plates. So it is in half-skirted format and tested to eliminate all possible variables to give you the best accuracy in your results. So we have them also in 8-trip tube formats as well. So it's really up to you if you want 96 or you want 8-trip tubes. So let's start the system. So you can start it by holding this green power button over here. So as you can see, we have a USB port at the front and also 2 USB ports at the back. So this is for your thumb drive connection, so for you to export data out. So we also have LAN and Ethernet cable for you to connect to your institution's network, or if you want to connect to external PC as well. So I have a sample plate over here, it's in half-skirt format. I will show you how to load this plate onto the Cielo system. So you will see that there's 2 buttons over here. Either is fine. So once it shows green, means you are ready to start using this system. So we can load it. And we can input our well over here. Yes, and we can start setting up our experiment. So let's head on to our experiment setup. This is where you can set up new runs and set up new users. So especially for some labs, there are multiple users per system. So you can actually add user. So for this time, we will call it test. And then under test, you can set up new protocols. So we will call it test 1. And then they will bring you to this page. So this is where you can select wells. So and select your dye, select your sample reaction volume, and your lead temperature as well. So let's go on to well selection first. You'll see that everything is selected. So this is in 96 format. So you can clear them all if you don't want to use all wells. So once clear all, you will see that it's black in color. And then you can select them. So as you can see, it's in 16 wells format. So just to highlight again, because our system scans in 16 wells simultaneously. So that's why it will be highlighted in 16 wells format. And then once you are done, just click OK. And over here, you can choose the number of dyes you would like to multiplex. So let's say if you want to multiplex 6 dyes, just select them all. They will be appearing in green color. So for your reaction volume, there are some preset volumes over here. Otherwise, you can choose other and input your desired volume. And then for lead, you can set the temperature or you can turn them off. You will see that there is an email button over here. So this is a special feature that allows our system to email and notify you your completed runs and data. So this is essential if you are running your experiment overnight or if some of you are working on the shifts during this period as well. So once we are done with setting up, we can click on next. So this is where you will manually set up your protocol. So you can see that there are activation step, cycling step, and melt curve as well. So under the activation step, you can edit the temperature, just click onto it and let's say you want to set it as 90 and then you can click done. You can set the timing as well. So if I want this to be 30 seconds, I just click 30 and seconds and done. So let's say for activation step, you want to have gradient. So our system is gradient friendly. Just go on to settings turn on the gradient, and then you can start, you can turn on, you can set your start temperature and end temperature, and then the system will automatically calculate 12 columns of temperature for the gradient. So once you are done, just click on modify and you will see this symbol over here under the step. So this camera button over here is for you to acquire data for this certain step. So just turn it on if you want to acquire data for this step one. So under cycling step, this is where you can have multiple runs for step 2 to 3. Let's say if I want to have 3 steps over here. So under step 2, I can actually plus step and then it will plus it on the right side. And then if I want to delete a step, I can just minus away the step. And then for the number of cycles to edit, you can edit over here, enter cycles. Let's say I want it 39, I just set it as 39. And then if I just want my cycling to be step 3 and 4, I can click my go-to step to be number 3, and then it will just cycle between step 3 and step 4. So let's say I want to have another set of cycling steps. I can click on go-to, and this go-to button here, it will allow me to have another set of cycling steps. Similarly, you can edit the temperature, the timing as well, and the number of cycles. So once you are done, you can choose whether you want melt curve. Just turn it on, and then we are ready to go. Remember to click on the save button once you are done setting your protocol. And then once we are done, we can click start. So under the running step, you can see that we have lead temperature, sample temperature in real time, and also your current step timing countdown. There's a bar over here to show your completion. So once it's completed, it will be green. And then there is a total timing of your step, total timing of your experiment over here. So for that certain step it is running, it will light up in yellow over here. And then under this graph, you can actually view the real-time amplification and temperature. So let's say I just want to view Psi-5, I can turn the other dyes off and then it will just show the graph of Psi-5. So if I want to view them all, just turn them on. And then under temperature curve, you will see the real-time temperature for your sample and your lead as well. So you can pause your experiment or you can stop them completely halfway. So we will stop it right now. And then there will be a button to show export over here. You can plug in your thumb drive and then click on export, and then it will ask you to choose which USB device you want to export to. So once you are done, click on OK or cancel. Let's move on to Data Manager. So Data Manager allows you to preview your previous experiments and also allow you to export old data out to your USB drive or through email. So under the test that we did just now, you can preview what was the steps that was created. Click on next, and then this was the experiment that you ran just now. And then you can click on export again or the email function. So under device settings, this is where you will see your device software version, firmware, serial number, and also the system status. So once it's green means it's alright. Set the date and time for your time zone. So under network, you can connect to Wi-Fi, Ethernet for transfer of data. Otherwise, the email, which was the special feature I explained earlier, which is to send your completed run and data once the run is done. So you can test it after you have set it up with your IT department. Under dye manager, so this was the dye list that was shown earlier when you were setting up your protocol. You can change the name of the certain dye in the channel. Otherwise, if you have certain custom dye, you can click on add dye, click on dye name, and then you can input your dye name and then the certain channel that you will be using. So we have preset channels over here, so you just have to see if your dye is suitable with our channels. So otherwise, you can test it out. So this is just a guide to show you how to test your custom dye. Otherwise, you can find this in the user manual as well. So for technical support, you can email support@azurebiosystems.com. Otherwise, you can email me, your local support from Excel Scientific in Singapore. So this is the end of our demo session. Thank you.